Hi, welcome to the making of Treasure. This painting is a commission piece by a professional scuba dive instructor. So he wanted to base his painting on his passions. He wanted it to be very colorful and surrealistic, so that's what we focused on. I never had painted a underwater scene before, so it was a bit scary, but it was a fun challenge as well. And I've learned a lot while painting this. For this piece, I used a Arches cold press block and Winsor & Newton watercolor. I started with very diluted washes, so I knew where all the colors had to go because there were a lot of colors and I don't use a lot of colors normally. So it was a bit of a challenge and it was a bit of overwhelming as well. But after I'd done all the washes, I could just turn my mind off and build all those layers up. In the beginning, I had some difficulty with keeping the highlight spots clear of watercolor. So I put the cotton swab in an absorbent paper and dabbed it where I needed highlights. But after a couple of corals, I could throw that away and control the watercolor more. I decided to give the background corals a different pattern than the foreground corals, so the foreground corals would stand out a bit more. The color of the background corals are a bit more muted and the foreground is more saturated and it has more shadow. In this painting I decided to paint the background first instead of the face. I normally paint the face first, but in this one the coral was so intimidating to me that I just want to get that done first and then the face, because I already had done two portrait studies of this painting, so I knew that the face was going to be okay. And the corals I had done some studies on too, but they were just new. I wanted this painting to be very high contrast, so the focus would be on the face. So I painted the outside of the painting very dark. After that I started with the hair, because I needed a value reference, and the hair is very dark. Because if everything is very light on your painting, the darkest darks may not be as dark as you see them, but they appear dark because everything is light. So you don't achieve a very high contrast. And when you add that dark, after a while, everything is going to seem very light in comparison. And you have to do everything all over again, because it isn't as dark as you thought. So I always recommend to add dark value to your painting at some point, to have just have a reference. After a couple of layers, I started to add details to the corals. I used a darker value to stipple on the shadow side, and I used a white gel pen on the highlight side of the corals, so it gave more texture to them, which draws your eye more to the foreground than the background, and gives depth to your painting. I decided to paint her body off camera because I had some difficulties with it. I had to have two phones with two references at the same time next to me, so the phone where I record with was in use. The reason I had difficulty with it and with the face, because the references had different lighting than I needed to have for my painting. So I had to imagine them and have different references for them. And there are not a lot of references with light that comes from below, but I think it came out well, so I'm happy with that. One thing I also learned from this painting is how surprisingly simple it is to paint bubbles. I could make a tutorial for you guys if you want to. Let me know in the comments. And now the tape can come off. I always really love this part because then you know the painting is really finished and I can be proud of the finished product. I really love how it came out. I don't paint a lot of full background pieces, but after this one I've been really liking it and I've been painting a lot of full background pieces. So this painting changed a bit how I paint now. Thank you so much for watching The Process of Treasure. I really love making it. I hope you liked watching it too. And I wish you a great day. Bye!